All right, guys, we are back. Now, before we get into it, let me let you guys know that Blindside and Chaos had to take a step away from the mic momentarily. So it's just me and my homie, Lady Chaos. We are here, and we're going to give you guys the new and I was about to say new and improved, but it's not improved because it's just beginning. This is the first time we've ever done it. So we're just going to say we're going to give you the new movie segment. So say hello to the people, Lady Chaos.
Hey, everyone. How's it going?
All right. So why don't you give us a quick rundown? You know, well, actually, let me give the people a quick rundown of what we're going to do here. Here on the movie segment, what we're going to do, guys, is for right now, we're just going to give you a brief movie review. But in the future, I'm hoping that we'll be able to give you guys maybe a short list of movies that we've seen or movies that maybe were surprises to us that we saw, movies that were disappointments to us, or maybe like our top three movies that you should watch when you get an opportunity. Like I said, we have a lot of things planned for the movie segment, but for right now, we're gonna with our inaugural segment, we're just gonna start with Miss Lady Chaos giving us a very brief review. And why don't you tell us what you're gonna be going over today?
All right, so I've done my first movie review, which I've posted on the site, so which is at theeditorscorner.com, and you can check it out and have a look at that. That was on the movie P.S. I Love You.
P.S. I Love You.
Yeah.
And I know that you said that's one of your favorite movies of all time, correct?
Oh yeah, for sure, man. Yeah, it's like really close to my heart. It's the movie that Chaos and I were watching when we, when Chaos proposed.
Oh, so, how beautiful.
So yeah, it's something that I hold close to my heart, and yeah, I would recommend it for any lovers out there or just movie people alike.
So definitely. So if you guys haven't got a chance to check that out, go see it. If you have seen it, go see it again, right? I mean, go rent it.
That's right.
Can't hurt to watch a movie more than once, right? So you said P.S. I Love You. That one's on the site already. So what movie are you going to talk about today with us?
All right. Today I'm going to talk about Draft Day.
Draft Day.
This is the draft day Browns fans were waiting for.
Sonny, I hope you're listening. You run this team. You're the general manager. You can fix it.
Hey, Tom.
Hey, Sonny.
Sonny.
Every year, someone comes out of this looking like a donkey.
Can you hear me?
Yeah.
Good, because tomorrow I got a feeling it could be you if you don't make this deal.
Let's talk about the draft. I need you to make a splash, Sonny. And if you can't do it, then I have to do it.
Just to be clear here, you're threatening to fire me, right? Your job is to coach a team I give you. They do it different in Dallas?
Yeah, they do. They win. A lot.
How is it that the ultimate prize in the most macho sport ever invented is a piece of jewelry?
We talk football?
We can always talk football.
I just want the team that I want one time.
You see things other people don't see.
Rewind that back to the start of the play.
That's one of the things I love about you. All that matters is what you think. Write your own story, Sonny.
I want this team's future back. Let's get busy.
Draft Day. History in the making. 224 young men are about to become players in the National Football League.
Bo Callahan, he's the surefire slam dunk number one pick.
Trade me.
I'm going to do what's best for the team.
This is the draft analysis we've all been working on for the last 2 months.
Just made a trade with the Seahawks.
Sonny, that's our future.
You sold a cow for magic beans.
How does the entire world already know about this, Mom?
Because I just tweeted it.
You're on Twitter?
You're not.
I love having the number one pick.
I hope that you would.
The Cleveland Browns are now on the clock.
It's go time, boss. You got rogue.
Who are you going to take?
What's happening?
Who are you picking?
You son of a...
I need 5 minutes, and then you can fire me.
I got Shawn Michaels on the line.
Sonny, are we trading six?
I quit, Sonny.
Don't quit. See what I do from here. You're gonna like this.
The football world is in shock, wondering what exactly the Cleveland Browns, Sonny Weaver Jr., is cooking up here.
You're not gonna believe what's happening.
You make this deal right now, say it with me.
An absolute stunner.
Okay, screw it. No more offer.
You're out of your mind.
Yeah, I am. Haven't I proved that already?
So, being that you don't know too much about American football, We'll have to keep that in mind when you tell us about this movie. But anyway, I'll go ahead and let you tell us a little bit about, well, go ahead and tell us about the movie. What did you think about the movie?
All right. So the movie's called Draft Day, and the starring cast is Kevin Costner as Sonny Weaver Jr. and Jennifer Garner as Allie.
Both very good actors.
Yes, I like them both. The genre of the movie is sports/drama.
Mm-hmm.
And so, So this is my second movie review. And so Sonny Weaver Jr., which is Kevin Costner, he's the general manager of, I think, the teams, the Browns?
Yes, the Cleveland Browns.
Remember correct? Yes, the Cleveland.
That is correct.
Yeah, that's them. And so he's now in, it's preseason, so they're doing draft day. And everybody's like, you know, getting excited about who they're going to get picked, you know, which team they're going to get, be able to play for and stuff like that.
Yeah.
So it's up to Sonny Weaver to make this decision. So he's got this decision to make, and while he is making this all massive big time career decision, which if he fucks it up,
he's out of here. Gone.
Yeah, like he's stuffed his team up, you know, he's made the worst decision of his life. So while he's trying to make that decision, he also has like this personal on the side type decision that he has to make as well. So he's got all this shit going on at once, and I mean, like, with his career, the decision that he makes can either break or make his team.
Yeah. And then, and if you don't mind, if we could briefly jump into his personal life, because I mean, I don't feel like it's a spoiler to talk about this part, because they kind of make it known at the very beginning of the movie. He's pretty much, I mean, let's just keep it real, he's fucking his coworker.
Yep, that's right.
And I guess you could say she's what, the account? She's the accountant for the Browns, I guess.
Yes.
I mean, yeah, do they really get into detail about her exact role?
Just that she handles the cap.
That's she handles the salary cap. Yep. And he's impregnated her.
Yes, exactly.
So he's dealing with that on top of what he has to already deal with on draft day, which is already stressful within itself.
And that's a huge decision. That's a huge decision. If you're a, like, single dude, you know, and like you got a girlfriend and it's only you and your girlfriend, and then all of a sudden, hey, guess what? I'm pregnant. Throw that into the mix. Man, that is like the fucking most craziest decision that, you know, you have to, I mean, right there and then you have to make that decision. And am I a man who's going to stand by what I've done? Or am I just going to say, look, it's not what I want. I'm sorry. I'll do what I can, and then take the quick road and fuck off.
Yeah. And I think part of the biggest surprise in this movie too, is the fact that Jennifer Garner even slept with a halfway near 60-year-old Kevin Costner anyway, but that's beside the point. We're going to leave that part alone. Right?
That's just,
I'm like, okay, you know what? We'll leave that alone. We're going to leave that alone. So with that being said, as an individual that doesn't know a lot about American football, what would you give this movie?
All right. Well, like I said, I don't know much about it. I probably wouldn't have personally picked it for myself to watch, mm-hmm. but after watching it, I would recommend it to any diehard sports fan and any movie lover to go and watch it. I mean, yes, it might be about sports, but, you know, the behind story and the backstory and, like, you know, everything else is, like, for any kind of movie lovers out there.
So you do feel like they were able to kind of crowbar enough other stuff in there in addition to the sports so that it could be enjoyable by people that don't even really know too much about football, basically?
Well, yeah, that's right. Like, if I can say without giving a spoiler, if you don't like the sports part of it, then you can just kind of like watch the romantic story of Kevin Costner and Jennifer Garner, I guess.
Yeah. And I really think about this movie, and if you don't mind me saying this really quick before you give your final score.
Yeah, no,
I really do feel like that, because me and my fiance were watching this, and I feel like they were able to stick the romance in there without it being too in your face. Because, you know, like, as a manly man, I felt like I was able to still watch it without feeling like this romance was, you know what I mean? Like I was able to watch it without feeling like the romance was invading my sports movie, you know?
Yeah.
And
so it was a subtle mix.
Exactly. Because I feel like
it was a nice mix of both.
Exactly. Because I feel like if they would have did it any other way, if they would have added a bit more romance, I would have felt like, I don't know about this. But I feel like they did just enough to kind of stick it in there without making me feel like, ugh. Okay, this went from a sports movie to a romance movie. I still felt like it was a sports movie. It just had a little romance sprinkled in there.
Or that it was a romance movie covered by a sports movie.
Exactly.
Like, we're going to use the option, like, we're going to use the highlight of, well, come watch sports something or other. And then, oh, wait, no, it's some soppy friggin' love story.
Yeah, like, P.S. I love... No, I'm just kidding. I'm just
don't
messing
knock
with
it
you.
Till you watch
I'm
it.
Just messing with you. I'm just messing with you. So, with that being said, so, did you want to give us your final score?
Well, one more thing first.
Okay.
My dislikes of the movie.
Okay.
Was not knowing the NFL terms, like spiking and plays and things like that. Like I was like, what the hell? I mean, but you know, once you watch it, you kind of like pick up. Okay, you know, so a spike is, let me get this correct, where he throws the ball. It's some type of
like a
throw that they do in it or something.
Yeah, spike is basically, for anybody that doesn't watch football, American football, spiking the ball is basically what they do, like if they're trying to stop the clock, like say if the clock is running and they're trying to stop the clock before they want to kick a field goal or do something like that, they can spike the ball and they'll lose a down, but they can stop the clock. So yeah, like I said, it's a lot of confusing football terms out there.
And the thing that I liked about it was that it had a good storyline and a great supporting cast.
Okay, yeah, so, I agree.
And
I agree.
My overall rate for this movie is a 6.5 out of 10.
6.5 out of 10. You know what? That I think in my book, that's pretty darn good. Especially coming from somebody who's not a big sports fan. So for you guys that are out there listening to this, check it out if you get a chance. Like I said, over here in America, it's out on Redbox. I don't know if you guys have Redbox over there.
No, we have. I've never heard of Redbox, no.
Okay, well, but look, let me explain it real quick for those of you that do not live in America. Redbox is basically something, it's like pretty much every convenience store. Like, it's just a big machine where you can rent movies for $1, basically. And when you're done with it, you get it for a day, and then you return it back within 24 hours. So it's just a very quick and convenient way to see new movies, basically, or new DVDs.
So it's like a video shop, but in a vending machine.
Yes, exactly. You know what? That probably could have summed that up a lot quicker if I would have just said that. So yes, you hit it right on the head. It's a movie vending machine.
Wow, that's kind of interesting.
Yes. You know what? As a matter of fact, when I get a chance, I will post a picture of it on the editor's corner.
Cool, for sure. Sounds
yes,
great.
Yes. So if you get a chance, check it out. Like I said, for Americans, it's out. I got it at the Redbox. It is not out on Netflix. So like I said, any other way, you may have to order it online or order it on pay-per-view. But for those of you in America, get your $1, go to the Redbox, rent it, check it out. Lady Chaos, I appreciate you coming through and doing this movie review. Did you have anything else to say to the people before we leave out for this week on the movie corner or the movie section or segment or whatever we're going to call it?
No, not really. Just, yeah, check it out. It's a good movie. Yeah, it's got a nice blend of romance and sports. You won't get overdone by the romance and you won't get overwhelmed by the sports. So it's a good mix. And yeah, just enjoy watching our movie reviews, I guess.
And amen to that. Lady Chaos, thanks so much for coming through. And I guess we'll see you next week. Now, we're going to see if we can get Chaos and Blindside back in the building. So we're going to take a break and hopefully we'll be back with those two. Thanks a lot. We'll see you guys in a few minutes.
Later.